Many consider bodybuilding to be a man's sport. Possibly the most legendary bodybuilder of all time, Arnold Schwarzenegger brought the sport into the mainstream over the course of his career. But no female has ever truly been able to bring the same amount of attention to their side of the ticket. These women, though, pay no mind to what people might think a woman is supposed to look like. They are bigger and stronger than 90% of the men on the planet, with their only true rivals being male bodybuilders and professional weightlifters. In this video, we'll be talking about 10 female bodybuilders who went too far. Number 10. Yolanda R. Hughes-Hang. Yolanda Hughes was born in 1963. She was born in the United States and has made a name for herself as a professional bodybuilder. Yolanda was born in Murfreesboro, Tennessee, and was raised by her grandmother. She was one of five children and she took an early interest in gymnastics. As a teenager, she was quite interested in personal fitness and sports, and she was a rather accomplished athlete. After finishing high school, Yolanda got accepted into Western Kentucky University with a full scholarship. She planned to continue her pursuit of track and gymnastics at the university, but soon she got into a local bodybuilding competition, and she came second despite having only 4 weeks of preparation. It was onwards and upwards for Yolanda from then on. In 1992, she managed to earn her pro card by winning the World Amateur Championship. In 1997 and 1998, Yolanda came first in the Miss International competition. She also competed in 6 Miss Olympia contests, as she became a regular fitness magazine cover star. However, Yolanda's bodybuilding career didn't last for long. After coming in third place at the 1999 Miss International competition, she retired from bodybuilding. Like and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get 1 week good luck for you. Try this, it really works. Number 9. Rosemary Jennings. Rosemary Jennings was born on April 5, 1963, and is one of the most celebrated female bodybuilders ever. She's an administrative executive and is an ISAA certified personal trainer. Rosemary started off her pro bodybuilding career by coming first in the middleweight division in the 1997 NPC Metropolitan Competition. She was able to come first in the NPC Suburban Middleweight Division. She first got into bodybuilding when she started going to the gym to stay in shape. At this time, she just weighed a mere 112 pounds and wasn't overweight. But she didn't want to get fat at all, so she made sure she stayed fit. Rosemary says she follows a strict exercise schedule. For example, she eats 6 meals a day and trains all day for 5 days a week. She's managed to build an imposing stature and a body that is every bit deserving of a bodybuilder. Number 8. Christy Hawkins. A lot of people think you have to ditch your brains and focus on your body to become a professional bodybuilder. However, Christy Hawkins showed that you don't need to do that. Even though Christy Hawkins has a hulking body that is something to behold, and she also has a master's degree in chemical engineering from Caltech nonetheless. At this point, we believe that there's absolutely nothing that she can't do. Things get even more interesting when you consider that Christy got into bodybuilding because she wanted to lose weight. She was quite heavy when she started training, and it's not easy for heavy people to lose fat and then regain muscle. But Christy didn't, and she turned pro in 2007. She was able to compete in about 4 tournaments during her career. However, Hawkins soon quit bodybuilding to focus on powerlifting. Despite this, she maintains her top-level bodybuilding physique. Since she's naturally strong and can lift up to 400 pounds, that seemed to suit her better. Number 7. Lisa Giesbrecht. Lisa isn't the regular kind of female bodybuilder. While most other women on this list picked up bodybuilding at a young age, Lisa picked it up in her 30s. Lisa was always fit, but she started taking bodybuilding seriously after she entered her 30s. Since she got into bodybuilding, Lisa has had a complete transformation. Her muscles are now well-defined and she looks like she's been bodybuilding her whole life. She's also pretty strong, as her muscles aren't just for show. There are videos of her online where she lifts weights like they're toothpicks. Lisa's body is a prime example of what happens when someone decides to make a change and take their body to the next level. Number 6. Irene Anderson. Irene Anderson was born in 1966 in Denmark. Although she was born in Denmark, her hometown is in Sweden. That's because her family moved there when she was 2 years old. As a young girl, Irene was always physically strong. In fact, she used to wrestle boys and beat them. As a teenager, she got into Thai boxing and became quite good at it. As a teenager, Irene Anderson also loved lifting weights. In fact, people always told her to compete, but she didn't listen to them for the first 36 or so years of her life. However, at age 36, she decided that she would start competing. Her first competition was the 2004 Lucia Classic, where she won first place and got her IFBB Pro card. From then on, she started competing in the United States. In her native Sweden, Irene is often looked upon as a freak because of her strange physique. In fact, some people ask whether she's a man or a woman. However, the case was different in America. In America, she's often congratulated on her dedication and hard work. Number 5. Kim Chizevsky-Nichols. Kim Chizevsky was born in Charleston, Illinois. However, she spent most of her childhood in Decatur, Illinois. Her father was a football coach, and Kim actually studied as a paralegal at the Southern Illinois University after finishing high school. While in college, Kim joined the dance squad and started doing aerobics. In 1988, she met her future husband Chad Nichols and started dating him. Chad directed her towards bodybuilding, and after just 3 months of Chad's instructions, Kim managed to place second in the light heavyweight class in the 1989 NPC Junior Tri-State. From then on, Kim started competing in amateur bodybuilding competitions, and she would manage to come first in all. But one in 1993, Kim went to her first pro competition, and she managed to come first. She also managed to come fifth in her first Miss Olympia event, which is definitely not an easy task. In 1996, Kim was able to unseat six-time Miss Olympia Linda Murray. In that same year, she came first in the Miss International competition, becoming the first woman to win both titles in the same year. In 1999, Kim decided to retire. One of the reasons she retired was due to gender discrimination guidelines set up by the IFBB that advocated for more femininity and less masculinity in the sport. Today, Kim is still regarded as one of the most iconic muscular female bodybuilders of all time. Number 4. Debbie Lazuski. Debbie Lazuski didn't have a regular bodybuilding career. It was tumultuous, and many times she considered packing her bags and quitting. She started training at the age of 20, and just 4 years later, she won her first amateur competition. However, in 2000, Debbie experienced a huge letdown in her career. Judges placed her seventh at a competition, and her dedication declined. As a result, she stopped competing and just focused on personal training to stay fit. She didn't want to return to the world of bodybuilding under any circumstances. However, she returned to the sport in 2005, and she was able to go pro a year later, and she's experienced huge success since going back. For example, since 2009, she's been placed in the top 4 of every competition she entered. Today, she's ranked 3rd on the IFBB Pro Women's ranking, and yes, she's all that at the age of 47. Number 3. Iris Kyle. Iris Kyle is an American female bodybuilder, and she's recognized as one of the best to ever get into bodybuilding. In fact, she's the most decorated female bodybuilder ever, with 10 Miss Olympia titles and 7 Miss International titles. However, Iris didn't start off her life hoping to become a bodybuilder. It all started when she moved to Orange County, Florida, where she found herself surrounded by ultra-fit people. She figured that she could also look like them, and she hit the gym too. Iris soon got so fit that she was hired as an instructor at the gym, and this allowed her to spend more time on building muscles and getting fit. She was soon approached by a local promoter who had a competition he was hosting for 2 weeks. The promoter asked Iris to join the competition, and she did. She also managed to win the competition. Vadwan told Iris that she could reach the very apex of bodybuilding if she wanted to, and she decided that she would reach that apex. The next 15 years saw Iris going pro and winning 10 overall Miss Olympia titles, becoming the most decorated female bodybuilder ever. She's also won 17 overall IFBB professional titles and 3 IFBB professional heavyweight titles, which is more IFBB professional over 8 wins than any other female bodybuilder. Number 2. Virginia Sanchez. Virginia Sanchez is a female bodybuilder from Madrid, Spain. Virginia started training for competitions at the age of 17, and she was able to enter amateur competitions at the age of 19. Even though Virginia is now in her 40s, she looks stronger and fitter than ever. Her quads measure about 27 inches and her biceps push 17 inches. That's a form that even amateur male bodybuilders would aspire to get. Imagine just how huge she would be in person. However, the shocking thing about Virginia is that she's just about 5'3". So even though she's all bulked up, she's rather short. Perhaps the saying "big things come in small packages" has never been more apt than here. Number 1. Alina Popa. Alina Popa is a Romanian bodybuilder, and she began her training at the tender age of 12. However, she wasn't training to be a bodybuilder. She was training to be a loose weight and compete in track events. At 19, she started weightlifting after seeing other women in the gym preparing for a bodybuilding competition. She weightlifted for 2 years, and one day her trainer suggested that she should go pro, and she did. She competed in lots of amateur competitions before finally going pro in 2008. Sadly, she got badly injured in 2015 and had to take a break from competing. But she was back in the gym soon after and was even able to place third in the IFBB Wings of Strength Rising Phoenix World Championship. Popa is known to be one of the strongest women alive, can actually squat about 400 pounds. That's definitely no joke. This is the end of our video. Now it's your time to say which type of body you like. Comment below, and you can watch some more amazing videos here.